Okay, hello everybody, Skynet 48 is back, and today I'm gonna take a look at the new event, the Rathuun. Okay, the most seeked award from the event is this Furex Rite. It comes with a slot and a catalyst, and it's actually a crit weapon. I don't know how to judge it. I would say it's not that bad, but okay. Now, you can start the event by going here, and there are three missions actually on Sedna. The first one is here, which is level 20 Grineer, and has a chance to drop four riders and so on. Interested mods, but I never saw any. This mission here is level 40, and the stance mod that it drops are not, they're not good. And then you have the Rathuun 3, which is level 60, and this one is actually worth your every drop of sweat, because you have a chance to get a Vengeful Revenant or Temporeal or Astral Twilight or something like that. So yeah, this one is pretty neat. Okay, then you have the Endless Rathuun. In other Rathuun you can respawn, but here you cannot, and the main idea is to kill as many as you can without dying. Now, okay, let's go. I'm gonna show you the third Rathuun mission, and then we're going to go to the Endless. The Rathuun mission takes place in a Conclave map, and the ammo, life and energy orbs are lying around, like in the Conclave. You can pick them up. You're gonna be battling modified Grineer executioners, which means they're gonna have special abilities, special powers, and they're gonna be a lot more powerful than the usual Grineer we're used to battling. Now, you can see I went as Wukong. You actually can go mostly as any stealth or tanky frame. Any other frame would, if you mod it right, could go, but I wouldn't advise it. I like Wukong because I can be immortal and still use my weapons. I have the combination of Rage mod and Wukong's Defy, which means when they do damage to my health, I gain energy, and when I lose all my health, I gain it back with Defy and use the energy I got before. So that means that I can be immortal almost forever when I get about 50 energy to start up the ability. Okay, here are the first wave of executioners, and I just got one shot by the sniper. Yeah, you actually need to be really careful because they're powerful. You see, they just destroyed 1000 life points, 375 and 740 in one shot, which is quite a lot. Okay, now I get my energy back by letting them damage me. Okay, and the fight comes off and I have full energy. Now I'm basically immortal, which means I can run around, kill everybody. I like to bring with me my simulator, because it's pretty powerful, pretty much one of the most powerful weapons, and it does aerial damage, which means I actually don't need to hit them. I just need to shoot near them, and it's pretty easy. Now, when you kill somebody here, you can have disables like in nightmare modes, and when you, if you don't kill nobody, you lose health, but when you kill somebody, you regenerate the full health. This is special to the Rathuun 3. Other Rathuuns have other disabilities, and every time you kill an enemy, its level rises. So the more you will kill, the harder they will be to beat. Did I miss anything? No, I think that's pretty much all. Now, you need to, if you're not playing Immortal Frame, you really need to be careful for the, actually for everything, you need to be careful for the Jet Kitak Ground Slam, for the Flamethrower, if she burns you, she's even more annoying here, you know, the Cat Lady. If she burns you, you're instantly dead because the burn damage will probably destroy your full health. And you need to be careful because the bombards shoot really strong seeking missiles, and the butcher can teleport to you, like with the Rift mod, with the new Rift mod. Now, actually, you could see that most of the new executioners use the mod that are dropped by the new Kyla, but I will demonstrate them later, and I already made a video how to beat her, so you're free to watch that too. Now, the main goal is to get to 25 kills, which is actually pretty easy here. Now, the enemies don't drop almost anything, only fusion cores, and it's a pretty good fusion core farm. You see, I'm not going to go again, I'm gonna go to the endless one. Here, with the endless one, you can get reactor for reward. In the previous one, you could get the sail, the emblem, and the drive weapon. So rewards are not actually that bad. Oh no! Not the. You must not die here, because if you die, it's game over for you. I just need to get some energy to start up the defy, and I just started up my defy. Okay, I'm free to kill them now. I'm immortal. Immortality forever. Now, my favorite location to kill them is in this place, because they all actually come to you, and you can just simply make a minefield of simulator balls here, and everything will die. I mean, seriously, you're gonna just come in and die, like this one here. The only thing that I find really irritating are the energy mines, because they drain your full energy, and if you're a Wukong or somebody that relies on energy to stay mortal, you're pretty much gonna get destroyed by that. So yeah, be careful where you walk, because they can be everywhere, so try to destroy any place you're going to. And what just happened? What? What the? No. Okay, let's go again. I have actually no idea what just happened. This is the endless routine. I went to the endless routine, did I not? The point is, it shouldn't end until you all die. And we didn't die. Nobody died. So this is quite interesting for me, what went wrong here. But okay, you don't get any special rewards from here, but you can get trophies for your clan. by combining all the kills you make here with your clanmates, and actually you can get pretty nice trophies. Let's do this. Shoot me a little, don't shoot me too hard. I need to get my immortality on. You know that I have my immortality. I just need to keep it up. I need energy. Yeah. Now I need somebody to damage me to gain more energy. Where are all the executioners? Seriously, one of us already died. Yay, I'm here. Damage me. Great. And it's over for me. That's what happens if you run out of energy with Wukong. I'm gonna do it. My personal best for now is 5:55. So let's game on. I'm gonna do it. The problem was my teammates were killing them too fast and I was pretty much unable to do anything. No, why? Hate this Warframe. And I'm probably gonna be dead when I come back. Of course, why not? Why not? Host migration. Well, go somewhere. Because enemies can kill you while you're AFK, you can't play. Because that makes so much sense.
This game is sometimes really, really, really buggy. I did need to fix that.
Now I need to get damaged a little, not too much. Where are all the executioners? Well, I think I found them. I need a bit more energy. Okay, thank you, Frost. You're being actually really useful. Okay, I'm just gonna go and get myself killed. Oh, thank you for the holy energy you just gave me. Now you can damage me too. I'm here. Just kill me. Oh, I'm so hard to hit. Seriously, This guy is such a bad shot. Okay, my energy is full now. Now I just need to watch out for the modified arc traps. All the ammo. Right. Cool ammo, bitches. Oh, there are only two of us left, and we only killed 15 of them. Let's continue. This is going to get interesting. Watch out for the girl with jet feedback. If she drops a mine, you will lose all the energy and you're probably gonna get screwed completely. Everybody's there now. Their levels are rising quite fast. Now, for the high level, if I would want to go, I know, 100 plus, I would probably have to go full stealth, which I'm not such a, you know, I would probably have to go Ivara stealth, but I always keep breaking the stealth, so I would probably wouldn't last long. I hate this freeze. It's really annoying. Oh, they actually drop something else. I think the cats drop some ammo and resources and nice. It's really, this is my spot because I always can get ammo back. Okay, where is everybody? Whoa. This was unexpected and cruel. How much life do you have? Why don't you just die like everybody else? Yeah, you see, that's better. Oh no, why, man? I'm really sorry to those guys that came in with me, but they're gonna have a great score too, so. I have a great melee with me. Did I took my Nikana? Hopefully it did. No, I didn't. Oh, no, I don't have a great melee with me. If I would, I could go around on a rampage. Well, at least I will level up my new fists, which is nice. Why don't you just die already? And where are all the other executioners? That would be a great question too. Oh, here's the one I like so much that keeps freezing me. Yeah, thank you. And here's the jet hitter one. It's probably gonna defeat me after a while. And it's over. 48. My best was 55 with Wukong. So it's your try. I've seen people go to 400 and so on, probably with Walker. And I would say Walker cannot lose energy while she's in her ultimate. So if you keep running around the energy points, you should be fine. So this is it for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time.